Hey there, this is Raj here. Today I have some exciting news right from my backyard out here in Ontario. It's about a new development in HIV. It's really exciting and it's very economical. So I'm going to talk about that. Let's get started. Welcome back, friends. HIV is a retrovirus that attacks the body's immune system. Chronic HIV infection, where virus slowly destroys the immune system, is typically treated with combined antiretroviral therapy, or CART. While effective at suppressing the virus, CART cannot completely eliminate it due to latent reservoirs where the virus remains dormant. All of us know about this. We have spoken about it for a long time, and that is a critical problem. The research breakthrough is that scientists from the University of Western Ontario and the University of Bristol have jointly developed a latency reversal agent called a multivalent HIV-1-derived virus-like particle, or HLP. This agent functions as a shock-and-kill biotherapeutic targeting and activating CD4+ T cells, which are involved in the immune response against HIV. In a study involving 32 participants with chronic HIV who were on stable ART for around 13 years, the HLP was shown to target and purge immune cells containing latent HIV reservoirs, thereby releasing the virus. The findings were detailed in the Journal of Emerging Microbes and Infections. Here are the key findings. The HLP was able to induce the release of a significant amount of HIV from latent reservoirs, even in individuals who had been on stable CART for many years. The researchers suggest that HLP could potentially eliminate the latent reservoir of HIV, offering a cure or remission for those living with HIV and receiving stable CART. So what are the implications and the next steps? Well, the development of HLP could contribute to the achieving the goal of ending HIV and AIDS epidemic by 2030, as set by the World Health Organization and UNAIDS. And HLP is considered affordable and can be administered via intramuscular injection, similar to the seasonal flu vaccine. Further studies have to be done. Future research will involve testing HLP on a larger cohort of individuals with different HIV subtypes, with the goal of determining its effectiveness across diverse populations. This approach is currently focused on confirming the lack of toxicity in preparation for human clinical trials. So, friends, overall, the understanding I have based on the article that I read was that this particular HLP contains a broad cross-section of HIV proteins, and it is able to activate dormant HIV. And when the dormant HIV gets activated, the CD4 T cells that contain the HIV become visible to ART, and the patient will still continue to be on ART. But as the viral load increases, the ART will come combat and kill the provirus, and also the CD4 T cell will be destroyed. And therefore, the latent reservoirs will gradually be removed. And it's the hope that for many people, it could totally eliminate the reservoir. And once the virus level is zero, potentially ART could be stopped. So that's the big news. And this is the first time we have heard about somebody being able to say with this level of confidence or assertion that it's possible to remove latent HIV. So that's brilliant news. The second brilliant news is that it's going to be very inexpensive, so not millions of dollars. The third good news is that it's just like the flu vaccine. It's intramuscular. So administering that, transporting that, all these things are not going to be a big hassle. And the fact that it is less expensive means it can go globally to everybody. Now, what I plan to do is I plan to reach out to University of Western Ontario and see if any of those researchers would be willing to speak to me. And if they are, then I could have an interview with them and bring it to you so that you can hear from them firsthand what the entire vaccine is all about, how it works, what are their plans, what is the time frame by which they expect it to be ready for human use, because right now they are not yet into human trials. They are looking at safety first, and then they will go into human trials. So that's the scoop, my friends, and I hope you guys would be happy with this, because it's the best news I have heard in a very long time. So I hope this makes your day, and I hope you guys have a great weekend. I also have a special announcement to make. I'm going to have live Zoom calls for members. This is going to start, I'm thinking I'll start it from probably next week. One Zoom call of maybe 45 minutes once a week. I'm still working on that because our members need to get something special. And as you know, we have discontinued the Hindi version of the videos because we were not able to get the number of members that we needed to make it viable. So my approach now is that if I do a Zoom call, I can address Hindi questions as well without having to prepare and record or anything. And this Zoom calls, I think, should be around 45 minutes. And if we have around 40 or 50 members, I think most of the questions would be common and we'll be able to address most of the issues and also offer clarification. That's an easier way for me to handle the Hindi. And I could do likewise for English as well. So English, Hindi, any language, you can join the Zoom call and we'll take it from there. We'll see how it works. And if required, we can always separate out the languages and do multiple Zoom calls. So that'll be a special privilege for the members. I'm still working on the plans. I want to streamline my production schedule see where I can fit the Zoom call and give you added value. And I would like to give a special thanks to the members who have stuck with us so far and the new members who have joined us. Thank you very much. And the Zoom call is going to be my way of trying to compensate for not making Hindi videos. So with that, my friends, I would like to... one more thing I want to say is that the English videos still have subtitles in Hindi. So it's not like we have abandoned Hindi totally. But that extra work that I was doing that has released a little bit of bandwidth for me because I was falling behind terribly in so many departments. So I'm just about catching up. So watch out for that announcement and I'll catch up with you again later on. Bye for now. See you later.